Hello students, welcome all again. In this session, we are supposed to start with some numericals. Is it? Numericals based on half wave rectifier, a full wave rectifier, or a bridge rectifier. Those three circuits without filter, that is most important, will solve some numericals on those three circuits, but without filter. And in next session, that is the second part, we will solve those rectifiers plus filter circuits. That is what your second part is. So in the first part, we will solve some numericals related to half wave rectifier, full wave rectifier, and bridge rectifiers without filter. And in second part, we will solve some numericals with those circuits with filters, like capacitor filter, then inductor filter, LC filter, or finally pi filter or CLC filter. Right. Now, before starting with those numericals, let us start with some revision. It means now what we will do, we will collect all the parameters of three rectifiers. Around 15 or 14 parameters we have analyzed. Is it for half wave rectifier, for center tap, and for bridge rectifier? So all those parameters we will collect first, and then it will help us to solve the numericals. Right? So that's why what we will do, we'll start with collecting all the parameters whatever we have derived. Right? One thing we know, that whatever parameters we have designed for full wave rectifier, that is for center tap, is same as that is of bridge rectifiers, is it? So instead, there is no need to have two separate columns, but as if we know that only two parameters are different from center tap and bridge rectifier. That's why we are having two separate columns here. So let us start with the first parameter, that is IDC, DC current. It's not needed to write DC current here, but still I'll write DC current, is it? Now what is the equation for IDC? That is IDC for half wave rectifier. We have derived equation as IM divided by pi. Right. Now the same DC current for full wave center tap rectifier, we have derived it as twice IM divided by pi, and the same equation is applicable for bridge rectifier also. So here also in third column I will write twice IM divided by pi. Right? We are collecting all those parameters on a single paper in this video lecture, just because I'm not going to provide a single note for you people, is it? So whatever I'm writing here on this whiteboard, those are your notes. That's what it is. That's why I'm not missing a single sentence to write it here on the board. Right. So remember one thing, we are not going to share any single paper as a notes for you people, is it? So now second parameter. The second parameter we have derived is VDC. Now what is there in first column? First column we have half wave rectifier, and for half wave rectifier, VDC is VM divided by pi. In case of full wave center tap rectifier and bridge rectifier, VDC is equals to twice VM by pi. So whatever we have derived, we are just collecting the information on a single paper. That's what the motto. In case of bridge rectifier also, I need to write the same equation. That is VDC is equals to twice VM divided by pi. This is second parameter that we have derived. Now, third parameter that we have derived is RMS value of a current, that is IRMS. Here I will write IRMS in column of full wave rectifier, and here also it is IRMS. Now, RMS value of a complete current which I got across load resistor is what IRMS. And what is the equation we have derived? For half wave rectifier, we have derived equation as IM by 2. And it is different for full wave rectifier. Is that in full wave rectifier we have derived Im divided by root 2, and whatever we have derived for center type rectifier, it is same for bridge rectifier. So here also I have to write Im divided by root 2. Right? This is what current, AC current basically. Is that so? If it is an AC value, I must write its RMS form. So that's why I am writing I RMS. Then fourth parameter. Look at this here. Fourth parameter is VRMS. That is RMS value of output voltage. Now, what is RMS value of output voltage we have derived here for half wave rectifier? Now, for half wave rectifier, it is Vm divided by 2. In case of full wave rectifier, we have derived VRMS as Vm divided by root 2. And same here for bridge rectifier, VRMS is equals to Vm divided by root 2. Now here itself on this sheet you will find the difference that for half wave rectifier the denominator is 2. Here for full wave rectifier it is root 2. Why it is root 2? Because voltage and currents are available all the time here in case of full wave rectifier. But in case of half wave rectifier, voltage and currents are available only for half cycle. So that's why it is 2, and here it is root 2. Now, and this is fourth parameter, and fifth parameter is power. Now we will write DC power, PDC. What is PDC? Power in the form of current and resistance. Power can be in the form of current and voltage, or power can be in the form of voltage and resistance. So what we have derived, what we have selected, what we have chosen is power in the form of current and resistance. So here PDC means DC current, that is Im by pi square multiply by RL. Look at this. This is IDC. Im by pi is IDC. IDC square multiply by RL. And we have selected the same form of power in case of full wave rectifier. But here the equation will be different because value of IDC is different here. So it is Im, sorry, twice Im divided by pi and bracket square multiply by value of load resistance. And here for bridge rectifier, I must write the same equation, that is twice Im divided by pi square multiplied by value of resistor RL. Good. Now see, till now we have derived DC current, DC voltage, AC current, AC voltage, and then DC power. Now let's start with AC power also. So AC power, what will be the equation? Let me write, it is AC power PAC. Here also power can be in the form of current resistor, current voltage, or voltage resistance. So what we have selected, what we have chosen is current and resistance. So here I must write whatever IRMS we have, that is Im divided by 2 bracket square multiply by value of load resistor RL. Is that in case of full wave rectifier, that is PAC will be, look at this, what is the value of IRMS? It is Im divided by root 2. So Im divided by root 2 bracket square multiply by RL, that will be the equation. So here it is Im divided by root 2 square multiply by value of load resistor, that is RL. And the same equation is applicable here for full wave bridge rectifier. So I will write PAC is equals to Im divided by root 2 bracket square multiply by the value of load resistor RL. Is it? Now this value of RL if I'm using in calculation of AC power, then what I need to write, instead of approximate, I can write RS plus RF plus RL. That's what. In some numericals, instead of using RL as an approximate value of RS plus RF plus RL, I have to write clear values for RS and RF, because in some numericals the value of RF is specified. Is it? If it is specified, then compulsory we have to use it. Here also, I have to write RS plus twice of RF plus RL. Now why twice of RF? Because two diodes are there, is it? So diode resistance of one diode has to be multiplied by another one. So that's why it must be twice of RF. Two diodes I'm using. Then in case of half wave also, I need to repeat the same. It must be RS plus RF plus RL. That's what an exact form. You want to simplify, you can write Im square divided by 4 multiplied by RL. Here Im square divided by 2 multiplied by RL, and here Im square divided by 2 multiplied by RL. So we are not going to simplify here. As for the demand and requirement of the numerical, we will use it. Now next, seventh equation or seventh parameter that we have derived is PIV, I think. Is it? Ripple factor. Let me write ripple factor. I don't remember the exact number that whether we have derived ripple factor exactly at the seventh parameter or what, but as I remember, I will write the parameter. So ripple factor in case of half wave rectifier, we have derived it is 1.21 or 121%. 121%. In case of full wave center type rectifier and bridge rectifier, you remember it is 0.48, or I can say it is 48%, and the same is applicable here. That is 0.48. It means 48%. This is ripple factor. Now, eighth parameter is efficiency. Is it efficiency? In some books, they have written as ratio of rectification. I will write ratio of rectification. So in any numerical, if you find that ratio of rectification is dot dot dot, then you should not get confused. Ratio of rectification means they are specifying the efficiency. Now what is efficiency for half wave rectifier? For half wave rectifier, we know that it is 0.406, or I can say 40.6%. See, 40% is the efficiency for half wave rectifier. And in case of full wave rectifier, it is 0.812, or I can say 81.2%, and the same is here for bridge rectifier. It is 0.812, which is 81.2%. Now those are eight parameters till now we have written. Now let me extend this table. We'll pick up the same color and we'll just extend the table. It will help us to differentiate between the parameters of half wave, a full wave, and even for the bridge. Is it? We are just drawing a separate column for each one of them. That's what it is. Now, okay, you remember the number. It's ninth parameter we are starting with. The ninth parameter is, let me use the same pen as blue one. So the ninth parameter is utilization of transformer. Is it? I'll write transformer utilization factor. Now what is transformer utilization for half wave rectifier? You remember it is 0.287. If you want to represent the same in percent form, you can write 28.7%. Now that transformer utilization factor for center tap is different from bridge rectifier. Look at this now. For center tap transformer and for center tap rectifier instead, transformer utilization factor is 0.693, or in percent it will be 69.3%. Now the figure of TUF will be different for bridge rectifier. Now for bridge rectifier it is 0.812, that is 81.2%. Look at this, that is the only difference in bridge rectifier and center tap rectifier, is it? So that we are going to consider as in a special case. Look at this, transformer utilization factor is different for all those rectifiers. It is 28% approximately for half wave, 69 for full wave center tap, and 81 for bridge rectifier. It means in bridge rectifier I am using the transformer more, is it? The utilization of transformer is more in case of bridge rectifier. Good. Now the 10th parameter, you remember your number, what is that? Maybe it is 9th or maybe 11th, I don't know exactly. The next number is frequency of ripple, that is FR. In case of half wave rectifier, yes, it is same as supply frequency F. In case of center tap rectifier and bridge rectifier, the ripple frequency is twice of supply frequency. Look at this, here also the ripple frequency is twice of supply frequency, where what is F? For all of them I will write in common as F is supply frequency. F is supply frequency, which is not approximately, exactly I need to write as 50 hertz if we are in India. Why I am saying if we are in India? We are all in India, so that's why it is 50 hertz, is it? If you use motor shed book, then they have used 60 hertz frequency, is it? The author is from US, they are using their frequency, that is 60 hertz. If you solve or if you try to check the numericals with which are there in motor shed book, then they have used F is equals to 60 hertz, and obviously your answer will never match with their answer. Good. So that's why intentionally I'm telling you that for India it is 50 hertz and for US it is 60 hertz. Good. So there is a small or little difference between your answer and the motor shed, whatever they have calculated. Then next parameter. Next parameter is peak factor, I think. It is peak factor. Now for half wave rectifier, the peak factor value is 2. Is it? Peak factor means peak voltage divided by RMS voltage, is it? That's what the equation. It is 2 for half wave rectifier, and for full wave center tap rectifier it is root 2. The same value I need to paste here for bridge rectifier. Is it? This is about peak factor, 2, root 2, root 2. Then next parameter is form factor. I'll write form factor. Now for form factor for half wave rectifier it is 1.57, where it is 2.22 in case of full wave center tap rectifier, and the same value is there in this column, that is last column, in case of bridge rectifier it is 2.22. So the next parameter, you remember the number, it is 13 for me. So let us, next parameter is regulation. Is it? And regulation, the equation will remain same for all those rectifiers, but still there is a small difference if I am considering the exact resistances present in the circuit. Is it? Exact resistances means I am talking about the resistance of a diode also. Is it? Resistance offered by the secondary of the transformer. Right. So in case of half wave rectifier, the equation will be RS plus RF divided by RL. Now, whereas in case of full wave center type rectifier, the equation will remain same, that is RS plus RF divided by RL. But here in this case, it will be RS plus twice of RF divided by RL. Is it two diodes are there? So resistance offered by two diodes will be twice of RF. That's the only change. I think we have used this somewhere in the parameters that we have defined earlier. Look at this third or fourth. Here it is RS plus twice of RF plus RL. Here we have used this RS plus twice RF plus RF in case of DC power. Is it? It means we are aware if I am solving some numericals and if diode resistance is specified itself in the numerical, then compulsory I have to use that twice of RF. Then next parameter 14th. Okay, let me extend the table with the same color. Okay, let me extend it. Now almost we are done with 13 parameters. See, before starting with numericals, this part is really important, because here you will get all the parameters on a single page in a tabular format. And after this, let me tell you that we are going to collect all those equations for all rectifiers and all filters also. So these two papers will definitely help you to solve numericals related to any rectifier with any filters. Now the next is 14th. It is PIV. Let me change the pen. It is PIV. That is maximum reverse voltage handled by the diodes which are present in half wave rectifier. And the value of PIV, it is Vm for half wave rectifier. And in case of full wave center type rectifier, it is twice Vm. Is it? We know that how it is twice Vm. We are not going to discuss it, as we are just collecting the equations, the formulas. Right? But in case of bridge rectifier, this PIV, again it will be Vm. Is it? That is the another special case where we are getting a value of bridge rectifier is different from the center type rectifier. Is it? So the transformer utilization factor as well as PIF, those are the only two different values that we need to define for bridge rectifier. Otherwise the rest of the values are same as that of center type rectifier. Right. Now the next parameter is, I need to write, I think we are done with 14. The last parameter is how many diodes we are using. Is it? That also write it as in comparison. Is it? So number of diodes, I will write number of diodes. In case of half wave rectifier, I am using only one diode. In case of center type rectifier, I am using two diodes. And in case of bridge rectifier, I am using four diodes. So those are total 15 parameters that we have derived during the complete chapter of unregulated power supply. Is it? Let me write a nice title for that. What should be the title? Let me write comparison of rectifiers. That is quite okay. Comparison of our parameter comparison. Okay, parameter comparison for half wave rectifier, full wave center type rectifier and full wave bridge rectifier. So this is what actual thing. So this only one paper, if you really want this, I can convert the paper into PDF and I can share with you. That is the only notes that I am going to provide you. is it? That is the intention that I am using this whiteboard to write everything. I'll share among you people, you check it, and that's what your notes. Is it? So this is about the comparison of parameters for half wave and full wave rectifiers. Now after that, what we will do, we have studied three or four types of filters also. See, we have studied capacitor filter, then inductor filter, then we have studied capacitor inductor filter, and even CLC filter. Those four filters we have studied. And so whatever we have done for rectifiers, now we'll collect the parameters for filters also. Right? This will make our job easy to solve the numericals related to rectifiers and filters, is it? So in next lecture, what we will do, we will collect the information about the filters, whatever parameters we have derived, maybe ripple factor or anything else, then we'll collect them, and after that, in next lecture, we will solve actual numericals. Yeah, so thanks a lot. Hello students. So as I have written the title as filters, we have already discussed the filters. Here what we will do, we will collect whatever parameters we have derived for filters. For example, the first type of filter that we have studied is capacitor filter. And now for capacitor filter, we connected capacitor filter for half wave rectifier and even for full wave rectifier. For half wave rectifier, what is the ripple factor, and for full wave rectifier, what is the ripple factor with the capacitor filter, that we will collect here. Right? Like this, we will collect the equations, whatever we have derived for capacitor filter, for inductor filter, for LC filter, and even for CLC filter. So why we are collecting those? Because it will help us to solve the numericals based on those filters. Right. So let us start with. So for half wave rectifier, the equation of ripple factor is, it is 1 divided by 2 root 3 f c multiplied by the value of load resistor. Right. Now what is the frequency? Frequency is line frequency f, and it is 50 hertz. As we are in India, it is 50 hertz. C means the value of capacitor that I have connected as a filter. This is a load resistor. This is a load resistor. Right. Now this is about a half wave rectifier with capacitor filter. Now what is full wave rectifier with capacitor filter? If it is full wave rectifier with capacitor filter, its ripple factor is given by a different equation, that is 1 divided by 4 root 3 f c multiplied by the value of load resistor RL. Same here, f is frequency, that is line frequency, c is the value of capacitor that you have connected in front of full wave rectifier, and this is what load resistor, is it? Now if, as we are started with capacitor filter, then the value of voltage, that is VDC, look at this, value of VDC, that also we need to define here. So value of VDC, you remember this equation, Vm minus IDC divided by 4FC. This is the equation we have used or we have derived while deriving equation of ripple factor. Right. Now what is this? F is a frequency and C is the value of a capacitor, whereas this IDC is a load current. Right. And Vm is the peak voltage. Let me write here, it is peak voltage. Right. Now we have another alternate equation also for this VDC. What is the alternate equation? VDC for full wave rectifier with capacitor filter. It is Vm minus VR divided by 2. Now what is this VR? It is a ripple voltage, or I can say peak to peak ripple voltage. I'll write here click to peak ripple voltage. And what is Vm? Vm is a peak voltage, is it? So this is about a capacitor filter. Now what is the next filter we have studied? The next filter that we have studied is inductor filter. So let me write here inductor filter. That is L type of filter. Now for inductor filter, what is the ripple factor? For inductor filter, ripple factor that we have derived is RL divided by 3 root 2 omega L. Now what is this omega? Here omega is equals to 2 pi F. And what is that F in this omega? It is frequency, that is line frequency, that is 50 hertz. So it is RL divided by 3 root 2 omega L. L is the value of inductor. This is value of inductor. RL is the load resistor. We know that. Now if it is inductor filter, then inductor filter with full wave rectifier, then what is the value of VDC? Right? The equation VDC that we will use while solving the numericals is it twice Vm by pi minus IDC multiplied by RS plus RF plus this Rx, small Rx will be there. Is that why this small Rx will be there? Because this Rx is the resistance offered by the inductor. So that's why this Rx will come in picture. Now it must be twice Vm by pi only. But see, now what I am doing, I am subtracting this term also. It is a practical voltage drop across those resistors. Know that? So obviously RS is there, RF is there and RX is there. Those three resistors definitely will have some voltage drop across them. Is that so? As if they are having some voltage drop across, somewhere we need to consider. So that's why whatever VNL that I'm getting, that is twice Vm by pi, from this VNL I have to subtract that actual voltage. So that's why every time while using VDC equation in numericals, I'm writing twice Vm by pi minus IDC multiplied by some resistances. Is that so? If RS is given, we have to use. If RF is given, we have to use. If it is not given, then even if you don't use those IDC multiply by the resistances, then it is completely okay. But if it is given, we have to use it. So this is about inductor filter. Now the next filter that we have studied is LC filter or L type of filter. Is it in case of LC filter, L type of filter or L section filter, the equation of ripple factor, that is ripple factor of LC filter with full wave rectifier, we have derived it as 1 divided by 6 root 2 omega square LC. Now what is this L? Is the value of inductor. What is that C? Is the value of capacitor. And omega is 2 pi f, whereas this f is line frequency. This L is line frequency. This is a ripple factor of LC filter with full wave rectifier. Now in case of LC filter with full wave rectifier, what is the equation of VDC? It will be same as twice Vm by pi minus IDC multiplied by the load. It means I can copy the same equation here. Let me use the same equation this VDC look at this here I have added the same equation. VDC. Mm. See, doing copy paste, it takes a lot of time. Meanwhile, I could have written that equation. This is what VDC for LC filter with full wave rectifier, is it? I just want to tell you that equation is same. Look at this. This equation is completely same as the equation we have used for inductor filter and for capacitor filter. Not for capacitor filter, but for inductor filter it is same, because in capacitor filter inductor part was not there and we have derived it. Here we have not derived it, but it is there. So that's why I'm writing this LC filter equation same as inductor filter. Now the last one, that is fourth one, is pi filter, or I can say CLC filter, is it? Let me write it as pi filter, or I can say pi filter. Now for pi filter we have derived this equation for ripple factor, that is ripple factor of pi filter with full wave rectifier. The equation we have derived is root 2 derived, what the thing we have derived, root 2 divided by 8, let me rub this, it is 8 omega cube L multiply by C1 multiply by C2 multiply by value of load resistor RL. That's what the actual equation we have derived for full wave rectifier with CLC filter or pi filter. Then we have written an approximate equation by considering the value of capacitors are in microfarad, is it? So what we have written, the approximate equation is, see, we have written 5700 divided by L C1 multiply by C2 multiply by the value of load resistor RL. But here what is the condition? Condition is C1 and C2 are in microfarad, whereas we didn't change the value of inductor. So L is in Henry, is it? The value of capacitors only we have considered in microfarad, but what about the inductor? Inductor is in Henry, so you can take any value of inductor. Now what about the value of VDC? See, value of VDC will never change for L filter, LC filter, or maybe it is a pi filter. So let me copy the same thing again here. VDC will be equals to, here it will be same as Vm. Look at this, Vm minus IDC divided by 4FC1 minus IDC multiplied by RX. Look at this, I'm just having a different from. Intentionally, I am writing this equation of VDC in the different form. It is Vm minus, looks like equals to, but let me correct it. It must be a minus sign. Vm minus IDC divided by 4FC1 minus IDC multiplied by RX. Is it? Otherwise, you can have the same form as we had in case of LC filter, that is VDC is equal to twice Vm by pi minus IDC and the value of resistances. Is it the same equation we have used in case of inductor filter? Here I am writing another form of VDC. Is it? So if you are referring some book and if you find this VDC is equal to Vm minus this, it means they are writing this equation by considering the practical resistances and practical current. Is it? Either you go for this equation, otherwise traditionally we have our equation, that is VDC is equals to twice Vm by pi minus IDC multiplied by the summation of all the registers, that is RS, RF and RX. Is it? It's on us completely. So which one to use? Now, after this lecture, what we have? See, we have the collection of formulas related to all types of filters. Is it the capacitor filter, the inductor filter, LC filter, and even for pi filter? We have collected all the formulas, and now this sheet, is it? This paper will help us to solve a design problems or numericals related to rectifiers as well as filters. Is it? So that is why intentionally we are having this lecture before starting the numericals based on the complete chapter. Is it? It is for our sake only. We are just saving our time to search for what is the equation that we have written while analyzing the rectifiers and filters. Is it? It will save our time. Is it? And another thing that I want to tell you again is we are collecting all the information on a single page just because I'm not going to provide a particular notes for any of the chapter. Is it? So whatever I'm writing here on this whiteboard, I will convert everything into the PDF and I will share among you people. Is it? And that will be your official notes. That's what it is. So you should not demand for written notes. Is it? Actually, you should not. That is not a good practice for engineering student. But still, I want to tell you that you should not demand for any notes. You refer books. Online books are available. Whatever I have mentioned in the list, all the reference books, those are available online. If you don't want to, then refer those notes. Is it? Alternatives are there. But you should not demand for a written notes to any of the faculty. Is it? So that is another concern that I want to discuss with you. So after this lecture, we will start with solving actual numericals or designing the actual rectifier and filter systems. Is it? So from next lecture, we will start with actual numericals. Thanks a lot.